Transponder keys explained. Today, we're going to be talking about the Ford H128 High Security Transponder key. Now, this key is used in non-proximity vehicles, ones that have a normal ignition, where you actually take the key, put it in, and turn. Starting in 2013, all the way up to at least 2021. I'm not quite sure on 2022 yet, so I would guess it's a high possibility. Now, before we get going into all of the information about this H128 key, I really want to talk about a few things because it's going to be really important and I really think it's good information for you to know. Now, when you look at this key, okay, it's a lot of times you'll see it called the T key. And the reason is because the blade is actually twisted from its normal position, okay? And why that's important really is this key blade, all right? The key blade and the code series and a bunch of other stuff here we'll be getting to is essentially identical to the H94 high security, you know, the 80-bit transponder key. So the blade is identical. You almost kind of want to think of it as like, you know, the Toyota, there's like the TOY 44 D, G, and H, right? The blade's the same, but the chips inside them are different. And that's kind of the same thing. That's more true than untrue when it comes to this H128 key. The blade is identical. So why this is important is that you really want to take the information that you know and what you're familiar with the H94 key, if you are, and kind of apply that information to this H128 key. It will be really helpful. Now, I just want to point out for a minute, you know, I kind of like the blade opposite of how it normally is, how it's twisted like that. You know, I don't have one of these vehicles, but it would really probably mess me up for a while, how you're used to holding the head of a key, putting into the ignition and turning it. I can't imagine for the longest time I'd be probably hitting it the wrong way, you know, trying to get it in there. So pretty interesting. Now, when it comes to the chip inside of this key, you know, it's that 128-bit, right? So it's a pretty big step up in encryption compared to the 80-bit that was before it, and then even the 40-bit that was before it. Now, this 128-bit chip is made by NXP, and a lot of times it's called the Philips 128-bit. Now, when it comes to the test key and shell, now I recommend the JMA shells, okay? The part number is the TP00FO-24.P2, okay? Now you can use that not only for a chipless shell, but you can also just use it as a test key. And this is where it gets a little interesting for you, okay? So that's the part number, the one I just gave you, okay? That's the part number for this twisted head key. You can also use, because the blades are identical, you can just use the basic H94 chipless key as well. As a matter of fact, just a little bit ago, I was talking to someone who has one of these T keys, okay? And they actually, you know, took one of the 128 chips and they put it in a H94 shell, so the blade's flat, like a normal key that we're used to, and it works perfectly fine. So for me, what I hear, okay, and what I recommend is just stock for the test blades, or the shell, that's the part number, and that way you can just use it for both the test key for the H94 and this H128, right? That'll save you a little bit of money, save you a little bit of inventory, save a little bit of hassle as well. Hey, if you like videos like this and want to see more like them, go ahead and hit that like button. Now let's talk about the code series. Now, this type of situation on this key, what I'm about ready to explain, definitely can stump you if you're not, if you don't really know this information or it's kind of new. And that's because this one key has two different code series. And you could probably guess it, but one of the code series is the exact same code series as the H94 key, which is the 10,001 to 11,500. So the specs, all of that is identical to the H94 as well as the H128 key. Now, the other code series is gonna be a 1 to 4,000. 1000, okay? And so there's the two different code series there. Now, why is this important? This is important because if you were to go decode one of these keys on a machine, you typically have to pick what code series that you're gonna put it in at. And a lot of times when you're used to cutting a lot of keys, it's easy just to put one in there, go ahead and decode it, and then you're gonna run into problems if you don't choose the right code series. So this is one of those situations that you just wanna remember. The H128 has two code series, and who knows, we could have more in the future. I guess you just never know. You know, this is one of those, just a quick little fun fact here, on the B111 circle plus key, that also has two code series, okay? And that has got so many people over the year. It has the S, typical 10 cut code series, and then it also has the G, and that has got a lot of people over the years until you gain a little experience. So just remember, the H128 has two code series, really important. All right, now last but not least, let's talk about duplicating this key. Now, as I've said it before, duplicating high security or laser cut keys on a electronic automatic machine is always the ticket, okay? But there are times where maybe you can't at the moment, or you don't have one. And so you're gonna have to use a manual key duplicator. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play a little clip of me duplicating the H94 key, because you're gonna duplicate it the exact same way you will this one.
All right, so I have our key here that we're going to duplicate, you know, on this blank key. Now, one thing I wanna point out just really quick, if we look at this blank key here, all right, you're gonna see right here, there's like this little tiny dip. It's almost like a little fake shoulder right there, okay? And the point is that when we're putting these keys into the machine, we want to make sure that that is sticking out of the machine, right? So typically we'd wanna get this key all the way in. The further you can get it in, the more secure it is, okay? But in this case, you wanna make sure you don't get it past that mark, because it's not gonna clamp it right and you're gonna have problems. So I'm gonna use this first. Let me turn it on just so you can see with the light here. So I'm gonna use this first line here, okay? And there you can see the kind of the angle right there. So what I'm gonna do here is put our little tip stop in. I'm gonna put the key in, okay? And I'm just gonna put my finger on top of it, because we wanna make sure that we get it nice and straight. Any sort of angle will most definitely cause you some problems. Move over to the other side, get that key put in, just like that. All right, so what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna turn the machine on. Now, forgive me here, I'm at a weird angle with the camera here, so I'm gonna try to go as smooth as I can without being direct on the machine. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna bring this down, and then right up here, there is a feature to lock it into place. So now I don't have to worry about that depth anymore. I'm just gonna go slow. You just wanna go slow. Let the cutter do the cutting just like you do with the drill bit. I'm just gonna follow all these cuts along here. All right. So we got that. So what we're gonna do here, take it off, take a quick peek at it. Looks good. And then we're just gonna flip it over and do the other side. So you just wanna take your time. It got away from me there just a little bit for a second. You know, that's gonna happen. You just want to try to prevent it as much as you can. So get that one put in there like that. There we go. Nice and straight. We're just going to do the exact same thing. Put it there, lock it into depth. And just take it nice and slow, let it do the cutting. All right, and there you have it. Go put that on the buffer wheel here for 1 second. And there we go. And that's how you're gonna cut one of these two-track Ford high security keys.
All right, so there you have it. That's all of the information that you need to know for the H128 Ford high security transponder key. Make sure you download the PDF in the notes for a nice quick fact sheet. But I'd really love to know, what do you think about this key? What's your experience? You have anything to add? I'd love to read it, and I'm sure others would as well. And make sure that you include the hashtag Lockboss to automatically get entered in to win one of 5 free prizes we give away each week on YouTube. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. This H128 key, the The blade head shape is a little twisted here, and that's why it's like this. No, well, that's why it's like this.